Hey guys, today I'm going to review The Queen's Rising by Rebecca Ross. I received this book through Edelweiss in exchange for an honest review, and this book is going to be released on February 8th. The Queen's Rising is a YA fantasy in what I think is planned to be a trilogy. I don't think there's any more information on that yet. I think that this first book is a story that is definitely wrapped up very nicely. I could very well imagine that maybe the sequels are from different point of views, but I definitely think that this can absolutely be read as a standalone. I think there is much more to discover about the world, but I think as far as this character's storyline, it's done. The character we're following is the 17-year-old Brianna, and she is at this kind of school for passions. That means there are 5 kind of passions. Now let me think if I can get them all right. Art, music, knowledge, wit, and performance? No, what's it called? Dramatics. So these are kind of the 5 passions. And when you start at the school, you choose a passion and then you will get kind of educated in this passion for the next 7 years. And normally you kind of start this because you already have a talent for something. But Brianna was sent there by her grandfather, who thinks this is kind of the safest place for her. But she does not actually have any of these talents. So throughout the time at the school where she's actually supposed to learn one passion for 7 years, she ends up going through all of the passions until she lands on knowledge. Then she is supposed to kind of basically graduate, but since she only had 3 years to really learn the passion of knowledge, she's just not at a level where she's supposed to be. And when you graduate, you're actually supposed to be with a patron, so there's gonna be people that you kind of audition for in a way. But there's no patron that wants Brianna, so she kind of has to find a different way. Then all these kinds of things unravel about her past and the past of this whole world. This is a very kind of political YA fantasy, and this is really only the beginning and really only kind of the basic layer where the story starts. There's so much more to it and a really interesting world. I fucking loved it. Now, I gotta say, this is exactly the kind of YA fantasy that I love. I was hooked pretty quickly. I was already going into it with pretty good feelings because I knew that it was kind of political and I just really, really like that. But I was not expecting to love it as much as I did. It's not a book where I was like, oh my god, like 5 stars immediately. I didn't even have to think about it. But I ended up just being so emotionally invested and just found this whole book throughout the whole thing so enjoyable that for me 5 stars was just the best decision. What I personally loved so much about this book and what really reminded me of Graceling was this simplicity to this book. Now, some people will call it boring. It was so great because it did not have to rely on any of the tropes. It was engaging without any of them. As I said, it is a very political kind of story. The world is definitely a world that has some magic in it, but it's not really something that we explore a lot. So it's not a story where the main character kind of finds out that she has like magical abilities. It's really just about like political intrigue and kind of overthrowing kings in a way. I thought that the world building was very interesting, and I love that throughout the story we unraveled more and more of the history, and the way we did it was very interesting and very intriguing. But there's definitely a lot more about this world. I think if you are someone who really loves world building, you're probably not going to be like 100% satisfied with this one, because the world is, there's more to it. There's a lot more to it. I also want to talk about the family trees. Now, I'm not sure if it's going to be like that in the final copies as well, but in my e-arc, there was a spoiler in the family trees. Now, I gotta say, it's not like a huge bad spoiler. I think it's something that you can kind of come up with yourself, but it's there and it's a thing and it might kind of lessen your enjoyment. I thankfully did not look at the family trees before I read it, but I just kind of wanted to warn you. Maybe they change it in the final copies, I don't know, but that's what was in my e-arc. So maybe just don't look at the family trees before you read it. I also thought that the pacing was very well done, and it's not fast. It's definitely a slow kind of pacing, and it very much has this first book kind of feeling, because it sets up a lot of stuff. but I never felt like that slow pacing wasn't well done. I thought that the pacing always fit the way it was. There were also a couple of things in it that I found predictable in a way, but you know how there's like a bad predictable where when you reach the point where something gets revealed, you're like, oh, that's annoying, I knew this all the time. And then there's other predictable stuff where you start predicting it and then you want to read on and on because you want to know if it's true. And then when it ends up being true, you're like, oh my god, I knew it! And you're actually excited about it. And I love that kind of predictable. That's my favorite kind of predictable. So I don't know, might piss some people off. I loved it. I also thought that there were a lot of really great themes as far as friendship and family. The book starts out with a really great female friendship group. Now, I have to say, this is really only the first kind of quarter of the book, because that is when we kind of get to see the school and all of the girls that have the different passions. But I thought even later throughout the book, there's still some great female friendships in it, and there is a pretty strong found family theme. I was never someone who like really loved that. I'm not looking out for these kinds of books, but this one made me incredibly emotional. I actually ended up tearing up in a couple of family scenes at the end of it, and I found myself to be very emotionally invested in these kinds of family, like found family relationships, and I really, really appreciated that. I think if you're someone who really loves this kind of found family theme, then you will really, really enjoy this. Now let's talk about the romance. If you know me, I am someone who cares a lot about romance. And for the most part, for me, a book will only get better with a romance. And this one was definitely one of these books. Like, without the romance, I don't think I would have given it 5 stars, gotta be quite honest. Because romance is very easy for me to get emotionally invested in, and this one was top notch. Now, I gotta say, I think I can get where some people find it annoying. It's a theme that kind of comes up pretty quickly in the beginning of the book, and the characters, they know each other for a really long time, so we don't really get too much kind of build up on that romance in the beginning. But at the same time, nobody is actually acting on any of their feelings yet as well. This is definitely something where you can already tell both characters have feelings for each other, but nothing really happens until the end of the book. And honestly, I just thought it was like such a small, subtle way, and the romance was just like, nobody ever had to be like intense on it. It was just like obvious at one point, like, I don't know. I don't know how to describe it. If you're someone who is not really into romance, you're gonna be fine. I think that you're gonna maybe suffer a bit through the first quarter because you can constantly tell that, you know, there's feelings involved. You're gonna be like, ugh, can you stop? But I think once you're through the first quarter, you're gonna be okay. That's what I personally would think for someone who doesn't really enjoy romance. So yeah, overall, I really, really love this book. I don't think that there's anything to really criticize about it. Some people will probably just not really enjoy it because they find it boring. But I really loved it, and that was exactly why I liked it. So these were all of my thoughts on The Queen's Rising by Rebecca Ross. I know a couple of people have also already read ARCs, so if you have any thoughts on the book already, I would love to know them. If you're gonna say anything spoilery, please put a kind of spoiler thing in the comments, or you can also always DM me on Twitter about a book if you want to. And if you haven't read it yet, I would love to know if you plan on doing so, and if you're coming back to this review 10 months after it's been released. I also would love to know your thoughts about this. I always love it when people comment on my reviews like 10 months later. I think that's great. Anyway, thank you so much for watching, and I guess I'll see you soon. Bye!